My name that I'm known by in the arts is Phyllis Zaballero, but actually my real name is rather long. Zaballero is my married name. My maiden name is Del Rosario. When it came time to decide who I was going to be, it was all as an artist, no? It was already, let's say, the second year that I was in UP Fine Arts, and the first time I was under Roberto Chabet. It taught me a lesson, because right away he said, all right, you're all going to become artists, you hope. But one of the first things you have to decide is how are you going to sign your works? I didn't even think about that, you know. And some choose their first name. Phyllis is kind of like some old English woman in her garden. Del Rosario, my real name, was too long and segmented Del, not nice. But my husband's name had a sort of strength, a zing, something macho about it. Zaballero. Connected in people's minds with Caballero. I choose Zaballero. All right, fine. Resulting in, for many, many years, if they never met me and I was doing this very strong, abstract work, some of it very, very geometric and bright colors, everybody who looked at them, not knowing who I was, would always presume I was a man, because my name brought on Caballero. I said, well, that's wonderful. Because I don't think you should judge an artwork by the gender of its art maker. It was the thing to do at the time, and it was sort of forward thinking. Growing up in abroad, in certain cities, I would always go to museums. Even alone, I don't know why, I just loved looking at paintings. And as I got into my teens, I fell in love with Pollock, who did all of those abstractions. And that's when I discovered Rothko and all, you know, the first abstractionists to come out. And I said, hey, this is something I like. It stuck with me all my life. One of the things that I loved was abstraction. And I didn't consciously think about it until I was in the class of Bobby Chabet. Ironically, we started by his making us copy the masters. Real classics, real masters, the old ones, up to Degas. That was to prepare us for abstraction. So there, I ended up with, number one, I loved geometrics. Number two, I loved color. But I had to interject my own touch. So it had to be something that I splash on, you know. So that's how it all began. And I was quite happy. I questioned myself all the time. That's how. Because the answers surprised me. I was doing the grid. From splash, splash, I wanted to be more measured. So I was doing the grid, which is one reason I'm tempted by something like this. See? I'm going back because of the grid. And I would paint the grid. Then it came to the point I was bored. You know, I mean, I always wanted something to happen. And I questioned this. I said, why am I painting the grid? It's because we grow up, we live in a grid. Our lives are run by the right angles. But within the grid, I would make little paintings. And so I said, I'm gonna get out of this grid rut. Slowly came out, and since I had been exposed to a lot of paintings all my life, and I love to travel, and I love to do sketches, so it all evolved, and I said, I was always good at representation. It's how I began with Donald Duck and and Mickey Mouse, and I said, my mother kept them. And I'm an only child, so she kept everything, every little postcard. And I said, why am I denying what I love to do? but I enjoy it. I'm denying representation because it was looked down on. It was corny, and it appealed to the uninitiated and the unsophisticated. Yet, if you were sophisticated and you looked at, no. So I said, no, I will do what I want to do. And it evolved, it became a mix of abstraction, and I'd throw in some representation to the point that I became totally representational. That's another thing. It has always been about color. For me, my art has always been color. We've got this Pambabae. When this came up, March was the month for women, it was declared. Okay. I was really, really happy when I was approached. I said, you mean to say art fair will give us, it'll be the title. In translation, it's for women. It's not about women, it is Pambabae. Tungkol sa babae. So this is for us. When Art Fair came to me and said that you would have a space, I said, but of course, all right. But the killer was this. It wasn't going to be my recent work because my work has evolved a lot from the... I've been in this racket for 46 years. So something has to happen, right? I said, what do you want me to show? You know, I have so much to show and a limited space. And when I was told it'll be about abstraction, I said, I never paint the past again now. I don't believe in flogging the dead horse, you know? From 1978 to 1989, I have my biggest painting, abstract, had to do for the opening show of the 13 artists at the CCP Main Gallery in 1978. Back then, they gave you a sum of money and said, you spend this money on your materials that you will use. So I produced a seamless painting, 70 feet long, 70, acrylic and pencil and charcoal and what have you. That, to me, was my statement. And it stayed my statement for, I would say, 15 years. Well, it's my abstract work. It's my beginning work. It's my youth work. I wasn't young, huh? That's what I had the advantage over some of my classmates. Myself and another lady, Ginny Dundun, who has died already this year, we went into the freshman year of UP Fine Arts, the two mommies. We had children, all of us. And I was told that the young collectors now are looking for old abstract paintings. I said, well, my early times have come around, but I've kept quite a few. Actually, without their knowing it, or even without us knowing it, we were one of the first to do a lot of a kind of art that we were doing, on top of everything else a woman has to do, you know? Better late than never, you know, that now maybe we will be given some credit. One of the frustrations of my life now, especially now as I get older, when I look at the list of national artists, I look at the list of the national artists, the names, the national artists for the visual arts, meaning painting, sculpture, printmaking, whatever. Not one woman is named that. And that maybe some young people are looking at old abstract art, which they think is trendy, but has been around a long, long time. It's a little, how would I say, depressing, because my state of mind is the state of my age. Because when you're young, or your middle age, you always think, I've got a long life ahead of me. And I was always putting things aside. You know, I'll finish this later. Or this is something that I can do later. Later has become now. It is now later. So I said, no, I'm going back to my roots. And I started cleaning with COVID. Not only did my hair turn white, I started cleaning out my drawers, and all of my sketchbooks came out. From day one, sketches. And I said, look at these little treasures. At a certain minute in time, I was standing up in this place and I was sketching this. It was, to me, more authentic than sitting for hours and days in front of a canvas. This bit of pencil or pen and ink, I always did pen and ink, okay? It's more me. So I brought them out, and now this is my new thing now. I have revived, given a second life to my sketches, and it's become what I call illuminations. Gives me hope that maybe my right hand, as long as I keep my right hand and my eyes, that's really all I care about. I think now is my time for tying up loose ends. And in my art as well. I'm bringing out my old art. Behind there is a forest scene, which I gave up on 30 years ago. And I rolled it up and threw it into my bodega. And we're cleaning the bodega, and I have rolled up paintings, hindi natapos, because I wasn't happy. And now I'm finishing them. I'm Phyllis Saballero, and I'm on Metro.Style. Thank you.